So Peter, you spoke so eloquently about the diversity within the Latino community. Now that is something that I have experienced, that a lot of people remain ignorant about, including within the Latino community. How did you become so enlightened? If that's the right word.
I haven't thought that. I mean, the first encounter that I had with the diversity issue within the Latin culture is just from within my own family. Okay. I have an Anglo father, and then I have an indigenous mother, and then in Peru, I have relatives who are indigenous and African. And oftentimes when I just saw like a disconnect when people were talking about Latinos or Hispanics. I don't necessarily use the term Hispanic because it relates directly to Spain. But from my own personal experience, being a darker-skinned Latino, there's a bias towards lighter-skinned Latinos, and that's even within my own family. Back home. So for me, as a child of someone who was part of these social movements, who was claiming pride to be Indian or Chicano or Latino, you know, I was a child of the 60s, I put that into question. And so even when my mom claimed her indigenous heritage, even indigenous relatives in the homeland were questioning her. Why are you doing that? Because to be called an Indian in certain parts of Latin America is still a derogatory term. So that's number one. And then you grow up listening to Latin music.
Yeah.
Some of the biggest salseras.
Exactly.
You know, they're African.
Right.
And then I think also being involved in capoeira, which is an African-Brazilian martial art, you know, for and going to Brazil, that's an African art. So for me, you know, also growing up as in the U.S., listening to, I grew up on soul music and hip-hop and R&B, so that's the soundtrack of my life. Mm-hmm. And because our community is right next to African-American, the schools are largely African-American Latino, you can't help but be influenced by the people around you. So San Francisco is a very culturally diverse place, and a lot of people are proud of who they are. So you have Afro-Brazilians, Haitians, Peruvians, Mexicanos, and everyone it seems in our circles was informed about who they were. So then you know hear these national conversations going on about what is a Latino, and something doesn't measure up. So for me, as a storyteller, I have to like question those things. And then when I go participate in conferences like this, where people are kind of generalizing about this complex group of people called Latinos, I feel compelled to say something. And I mean, you can say the same thing about conversations about what is an American. People accept that an American can be a multitude of things. And so for me, to bring that understanding and apply it to the term Latino is really important.